Dear student, a very good afternoon to all of you. Welcome back to the series of discussion on compressible flow. Today, we are going to continue for the numerical solution based on compressible flow. So on the screen, it is showing the problem. Let's read it out first. A stream of air flows in a duct of 100 mm diameter at a rate of 1 kg per second. The stagnation temperature is 37 degrees centigrade. At one section of duct, the static pressure is 40 kilopascal. Calculate the Mach number, velocity, and stagnation pressure at this section. So this numerical and the next numerical I have taken from Basic and Applied Thermodynamics by P. K. Nag. So to solve this numerical, you have to follow the standard procedure that is required for solving a numerical of a problem of thermodynamics. That means there are the certain steps that you need to follow. First of all, you should understand the numerical or problem given, and you should write in one or two languages what you have understood, or you can write down the problem statement. Thereafter, you need to write down what need to determine. That means to find. Thereafter, you should write down the schematic diagram. You should draw it and label it. Also, schematic diagram and data given. All the data that is known, you should show on the schematic diagram. Thereafter, you should start the analysis part. So the all standard steps you should make habit in order to solve a thermodynamic problem. In previous numerical, I have used that. I have shown how to use it or how you can write down. So for the present problem, directly we will move on to analysis part. So let us see what it is given. Here the mass flow rate is given as 1 kg per second. Let us denote it as omega. Depending on the different kind of literature, they denote by some another nomenclature. Here mass flow rate is denoted by omega. Earlier, we use somewhere at m dot. So omega is given as 1 kg per second. The diameter of the duct is given 100 mm. So by using this diameter, we can determine the area as pi by 4 t square. Where diameter, if we need the diameter in SI unit, so we need to convert mm into meter by multiplying a factor 10 power minus 3. The stagnation temperature is given as 37 degrees centigrade. You need to convert it in Kelvin by adding 273. So the stagnation temperature will become 37 plus 273 is equal to 310 Kelvin. The static pressure is given as 40 kilopascal. Let us denote it as P is equal to 40 kilopascal. For air, gamma is 1.4. Since it is not mentioned, we can take it as a 1.4. R value, we are knowing it as 0.287 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. We should keep attention. We should give the proper attention over the unit of each and every parameter. So let us determine first mass flow, Mach number. We need to determine different parameter like Mach number, velocity, stagnation, pressure. So let us determine first mass Mach number. So it is given the mass flow rate as 1 kg per second. We can write for a fluid flowing the mass flow rate in terms of rho AV, where rho is the density, A is the area, and V is the flow velocity. So if we can bring this A from right hand side to left side, that means omega upon A, then it will become rho V. Also from the ideal gas equation, that is P is equal to P PV is equal to MRT. So P will become M upon V, we can write down as rho. So P will become rho RT. Therefore, we can write rho as P upon RT. So we can substitute P as P upon rho as P upon RT. Now we are knowing a relationship M is equal to V upon C. That means Mach number is velocity of flow to the sonic velocity. So the velocity of flow can be write down sonic velocity into Mach number. And we are knowing that for a idle gas, the sonic velocity is square root of gamma RT multiplied by M will give velocity V. So we are substituting that these two expression in the mass flow rate per unit area expression. Instead of rho, it is PRT, P upon RT, V square root of gamma RT into M. Now we are going to rearrange it and we are multiplying and dividing by square root of T naught. So the expression will not change, but it will come as a form of T naught upon T. So this stagnation temperature ratio we can write down as 1 plus gamma minus 1 upon 2 m square. Therefore, we got mass flow rate per unit area as and this expression. Now, in this expression, everything is given. We are knowing all the data except Mach number. So by substituting all the data, say omega is 1 kg per second, a is pi by 4, this much. Gamma is 1.4, R is 0.287 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, P is given 40 megapascal, M you need to determine, T naught it is given as 310 kilopascal Kelvin, gamma is 1.4, Mach number is again unknown. So in this equation, only M is unknown. So by simplification, you can determine the Mach number value by the simple mathematical calculation. You will be able to determine it as Mach number is equal to 0.76. So it was the first quantity that need to determine. So Mach number we are finding here as 0.76. Now we have an express, you need to determine the sonic velocity. So what is the sonic velocity? Sonic velocity is defined as by the expression gamma square root of gamma RT. Gamma is known as 1.4, R is known as 0.287, but we are not knowing the temperature. So how we will determine the temperature? We have an expression for the stagnation temperature ratio. T naught upon T is equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 upon 2 m square. So here T naught is given. Gamma we are knowing, M we have calculated, but by using this equation we can determine the temperature value. So by substituting these all remaining quantities value, we have calculated the T value as 310 upon 1.116, 277.78 Kelvin. So the temperature value that we got as 277.78 Kelvin. So by using this temperature, we are able to determine the sonic velocity, and we got, after substituting the data and calculating, it is found as 334.08 meter per second. Now we have the relation. We have the relation for Mach number. We have the relation for the Mach number. M is equal to V upon C. So this velocity we can determine as a V is equal to Mach number into sonic velocity. So by sonic number, sonic velocity, just we have calculated it as 334.08. Mach number we have calculated it as a 0.76. So by substituting these two and multiplying together, we got 253.9 meter per second. Next, we need to determine the stagnation pressure. So we have for the isentropic flow, we have the relationship between pressure and temperature. By using that relationship, we can write down the expression for the in terms of P naught and T. So P naught upon P is equal will become T naught upon T. That is the pressure ratio is related to the stagnation temperature ratio. Stagnation pressure ratio is related to the stagnation temperature ratio by this expression, in which pressure, static pressure is knowing, stagnation temperature ratio we have determined as 1.1.6. Gamma value is given. So by substituting these two values, we can determine P naught value as 58.72. So in this way, we have calculated all the required data that needs to be determined in this problem. So let's move on to the next numerical. Say, it is showing on your screen that a convergent divergent nozzle has a throat area 500 mm square and an exit area of 1000 mm square. Air enters the nozzle with a stagnation temperature of 360 Kelvin and a stagnation pressure of 1 megapascal. Determine the maximum flow rate of air that nozzle can pass. When the maximum mass flow rate the nozzle can pass, when the Mach number at the throat will become 1. Under that condition, the nozzle will have the maximum mass flow rate. So, see here, determine the maximum mass flow rate of air that nozzle, maximum mass flow rate that a nozzle can pass. Indirectly, it is given as at the throat, m is equal to 1. So, it is given since the max mass flow rate is maximum. And the static pressure you need to determine, static temperature you need to determine, Mach number and velocity at the exit of the nozzle. So it is just a two part. The first part, it is saying that the divergent section of the convergent divergent nozzle, it may act as a nozzle or as a diffuser. So one by one, we need to consider that divergent part of the nozzle first acting as a nozzle, then it is acting as a diffuser. So this problem, let us solve by using gas table for isentropic flow. So in this problem, I'm going to demonstrate how to use gas table. So let us have a look upon what is the gas table. The gas table is, you can find in your literature at the appendix section. So here, this table I have taken from the basic and applied thermodynamics by PKNR. So it is given in the appendix in under table 810. So see here, this is the gas table for which isentropic flow. There is the many parameter shown here. The first parameter is Mach number. What is the Mach number here? This is the Mach number at a particular section. M star, this is the Mach number at throat. This is the area ratio. That means the area at a particular section divided by the throat area. Similarly here, pressure divided by stagnation pressure, density divided by density, stagnation density, temperature divided by stagnation temperature. See here, you can choose one section, you can choose at a particular section. So corresponding to that section, whatever the area will be, and at that corresponding Mach number, corresponding pressure, and this is the corresponding density and corresponding temperature. See how, what is the if we can consider a convergent divergent type, a convergent divergent type. So in that case, see here, if we consider the convergent divergent type of the nozzle, so what is the convergent divergent type of nozzle? See, in the right side, this is the figure for the convergent divergent type of the nozzle. This is the nozzle which is connected to a fluid flowing. That means this is the inlet of the nozzle, this is the inlet of the nozzle, and this is the exit of the nozzle. And this is the cross section where the nozzle has minimum cross section area, and that is called as throat. Let us denote at the entrance, it is section 1-1. At the exit, it is 2-2, and at the throat it is star star. So this is the notation by which we are going to use. That means this is the inlet, this is the exit, and this is the throat. So there are the three important cross section or section in the convergent divergent which is of the importance. So if we consider the section 1, then this will become A1 and corresponding Mach number will become M1, this will become Rho1, and this will become P1, this will become Rho1, and this will become T1. If it is at section 2, so the corresponding area will become A2 upon A star, this will become M2, this will become T2 upon P0, this will become Rho2 upon Rho0, this will become T2 upon T0. So let us move. So in the problem it is given that the velocity is being asked at the exit nozzle, and the maximum flow rate at throat area. So we will take the area ratio between these two. That means we will take the A star is given in the table, but A upon A star is given. So we have to consider at section 2. Therefore, it will become A2 upon A star, which is found as a 2. So by using this gas table for isentropic flow corresponding to A2 upon A star is equal to 2. Let us find out. Let us see. This is the A upon A star. That means if you have A2, consider A2, so it will become A2 upon A star. Let us see, there is a different value of the A2 upon A star. Starting from, it may vary. See, there is a different value it is given. There is a different value, it is continuing. Starting it, see here, it is the different values starting from infinity to infinity. Now, what we have calculated it as A2 upon A star, we have found 2. A2 upon A star, let us see where we are finding 2. 2, this is not the 2, this will not found as a 2. So, if we are looking at the third row, we will find that 2 will lie somewhere in between these two quantity. Also, if you are looking upon another quantity, another location, then again you will find that 2 will lie again here also. That means the A2 upon A star is lying at the two different location. What does that mean? See here. Let's see at one location. See, it is finding here in between 1.5901 and 2.0351. So 2 will lie in between these two. How will we locate? By using interpolation. Okay. So corresponding to 2 value, what is the critical Mach number? That is 0.32572. That means this is the Mach number at the throat, and this is the Mach number at exit, because we have considered the A2. So it will become M2. So M star is 0.32572 and M2 is 0.30. So what do you observe? At the throat, the Mach number is higher than that of at the exit. Means velocity is continuously decreasing from throat to exit. That means the pressure will increase from throat to exit. When the pressure will continuously increase from in a divergent section from the throat to exit, then this will act as a diffuser. That means this is given, this is the 2 value that we have found here, that is corresponding for diffuser. Now if we can the divergent, see, there were the 2 cases. The divergent section may act as a convergent nozzle as well as diffuser depending on the condition. So if it is satisfying this condition, then it will act as a diffuser. So both cases we will consider one by one. If we can find out what exact value of the Mach number is when the A2 upon A star is 2. So when it is 2.0351, the M2 is 0.30. When it is 1.5901, it is 0.4. Then the question is, when A2 upon A star is 2, then what will be the value of M2? So using interpolation, we can determine that corresponding to 2 value, the value we got it as a 0.308. You can realize that our answer is correct. Why? Because 2 is lying in near to the high 2.0351. So this value should also lie near the 0.3. So it is lying. So this all the data now we have located. If the divergent section is diffuser, then we can determine M2 as a 0.308. Again, P2 upon P0 we can determine through the interpolation by using these two data. So we can determine by using these two data as a P2 upon P0 ratio. Again, we can determine T2 upon T0 corresponding to these two and these two through the interpolation. That means from this guess table, we can know the value of M2, P2 upon P0 and T2 upon T0. That means T2 upon T0. In a similar fashion, let us see in another location where we found it as a A2 upon A star H2. So here what we observed, when it is 1.8369, then the Mach M star, that is the Mach number at throat, is 1.6769 and M2 is 2.10. So the Mach number is increased at exit as that of from the throat. That means velocity is increasing. So this divergent passage will act as a nozzle. So this is the condition when we are considering the divergent section as a nozzle. That means we need to take the A2 upon A0, A2 upon A star as a 2, like here. So similar fashion, by using interpolation, we can determine the corresponding value of 2 as 2.197, which lie between these two, because 2 is lying in between 2. So M2 we can determine 2.197, corresponding P2 upon P star value we can determine through the interpolation 0.0939. Also by using interpolation T2 upon T0, T2 upon T star, we can determine as a 0.5089. So by read out this gas table for isentropic value, we have different values corresponding to when the divergent passage is diffuser as well as when the divergent passage is nozzle. When it is nozzle, the Mach number is 2.197. When it will act as a diffuser, the M2 value will become 308. So this information we have got from the gas table. So what we have got, M2, we have got two value, M2 2.197 and 0.308. So in the question A, the first part, it is given as a nozzle. Then the divergent section acts as a nozzle. When it will act as a nozzle, the M2 will become 2.197. When it become 2.1, M2 is 2.197, the corresponding P2 upon P0, we can read out as a 0.0939 and T2 upon T0 as a 0.5089. This is the data that has been read out from the gas table for isentropic flow. So from these two ratio, as the stagnation pressure is already given as a 1 MPa, in the problem it is given as a stagnation pressure of 1 MPa, so it will be the 1000 kPa. So P0 is given 1000 kPa. By multiplying these two, we can determine P2 value as 93 kPa and T2 value as a 183 Kelvin. So T2 and P2 we are knowing. Now we are determining we know to the T2 value. So the corresponding to this temperature, by using the equation for sonic velocity for ideal gas as a gamma square root of gamma r T2, we can determine the C2 value. Why? The gamma for the air is 1.4, R is 0.287 into 10 to power 3, and T2 will be into T2. So by substituting T2 value, how much? 183.2 Kelvin. After calculation, you will get a numerical value as 271.2 meter per second. Now you got the sonic velocity. You have Mach number. So corresponding actual velocity of the flow you can determine by using the Mach relation, Mach number relation, which is the M2 will be V2 upon C2. So this V2 will become the C2 into M2. So V2 we got the value as a 596 meter per second. Now we need to determine the mass flow rate corresponding to the maximum flow of air. When the maximum mass flow rate will occur through the nozzle, when at the throat the Mach number will become 1. So let us, what is the expression for the mass flow rate under the steady state? The mass flow rate, say here denoted as omega, that will be equal to rho AV at throat at section 2 exit at the section 1 inlet. So under steadily fluid flowing, the mass flow rate at the all three section will remain constant. Since we need to determine the mass flow rate corresponding to the throat section, then we need to consider at the throat. So we are considering the equation omega is equal to A star, rho star and V star. See, area at the throat is given as a 500 mm square. Rho star we are not knowing, velocity at the throat we are not knowing. So let us determine density at the throat and velocity of the throat. Once we determine density at throat and velocity at the throat, we can determine the mass flow rate at the throat. So what will be the density of the throat? We can determine, we can write down the ideal gas equation rho as a P upon RT. That means P star upon RT star. R value will be the 0.287. So let us consider, determine one by one. So this is the P star upon P naught formula for the critical at the throat, when for the corresponding to the maximum mass flow rate. That means when under critical situation, the P star upon P naught will become the formula as a 2 upon gamma plus 1 to the power gamma upon gamma minus 1. So in air has the value gamma as 1.4, then P star upon P naught will become 0.528, and T star upon T naught will become, by the using this formula, T 2 upon gamma plus 1, gamma value will become 1.4. So T star upon T naught is equal to 0.833. So we know the critical pressure ratio and critical temperature ratio by using these two formula. So let us calculate the, we need to determine the mass flow rate, in which first of all you need to determine the velocity. So in the velocity section at the throat, the Mach number is 1. So by using Mach number is equal to 1, we can have the actual flow velocity will be equal to the sonic velocity. So for the velocity at the critical section under maximum mass flow rate, we can determine the formula directly. We can use the formula for the sonic velocity. That means a square root of gamma RT star. Why? Because M is equal to 1. That means M is equal to V upon C, and V upon C is equal to M is equal to 1. That means V will come C. That means V star will become C star, and C star is gamma square, a square root of gamma RT star. So by substituting gamma R value and T star value, we can determine the value of V star. So what is the T star value? Now you need to determine the T star value. So T star value, by using this relation, T star will become 0.833 into T naught. What is the T naught? Stagnation temperature, that is given. So T critical temperature we can determine as a 300 Kelvin. Now let us we need to calculate the density, critical density. So by using the formula rho star is equal to P star upon R T star, we can determine the value for rho star. What is the P star? P star, by using these two formula, P naught is given as 1 megapascal, that means 1000 kilopascal into 0.528. That means 5.528 is multiplied by 1000 kilopascal divided by R is the 0.287 and T star is 0.833 into T naught. So by substituting all the data and doing calculation, we will got the rho star as 6.13 kg per meter cube. Now we got the rho star, we got the V star, and we have the A star. So for the mass flow rate, rho star, A star, V star, by substituting all these three data, we can determine at a 1.065 kg per second. This is the maximum mass flow rate at the throat. When it will be the maximum mass flow rate? When the nozzle has been choked, or when it will get choked? When at the throat the Mach number is 1. That's why we have used this formula. So because this is what is being asked, so this is the our final answer. Now let us consider the divergent part. This divergent part is acts as a diffuser. So in this case, when the divergent part is acting as a diffuser, so corresponding to the A2 upon A star value is equal to 2. From the gas table, we read it out as 0.308. Also, P2 upon P0 will be 0.936. T2 upon T0, from the graph, it will become 0.9812. So again, in the similar fashion, we can determine all the remaining parameter. So P2 will be the 0.936 multiplied by P0. So we got the value as a 936 kilopascal. T2 will become 0.9812 into 360, 353.2 Kelvin. So C2 again, how we will determine the velocity? C2 will become, so to determine the velocity V2, see here, it is not corresponding to Mach number 1, but corresponding to value M is equal to 3.308. So we are going to determine M2, we are going to determine the V2 corresponding to mass flow, Mach number 0.308. So how we will determine? V2 will become M2 into C2. So let us calculate the value of C2 by using the formula square root of gamma R T2. So T2 value is 353.2 Kelvin. So C2 will become 376.8 meter per second. So by multiplying C2 and M2, we will get a value of 116 meter per second. Also, you can determine the mass flow rate as a rho 2 A2 V2. Then after the calculation, you will get the omega value, mass flow rate, as a 1.065 kg per second. However, in the previous this point, we have already calculated that will remain same, and that's why we have written directly omega will become 1.065 kg per second. So in this way, you have learned how to use the gas table for isentropic flow. So I hope you have enjoyed the present discussion. So keep learning. So today we will stop here. So you should start, you should keep learning, stay safe, stay home, and continue follow our the discussion. So let's conclude today and stop here only. So today we have practiced, we have, that means we have learned the two numericals. First is the mainly we have learned the application of the gas table, how to use it. So we will stop here only. So thank you. Thank you for listening to me.